Mon reminded in Renault Williams Capes. Newborn infant escapes serious accident with little harm. Guy oil truck springs a leak in diamond. And why banning artists will not stop youth violence. I am Noriko Belfort, and this is Uncut News. Do you see news happening? Send us a tip on WhatsApp at 592-659-6151. Today, Daniel Melbourne faced the magistrate's court for the death of 50-year-old Renault Williams. He faces multiple charges, including causing death by dangerous driving, failure to report an accident, failure to render assistance after an accident, failure to produce vehicle for examination, giving false information to the police, and attempting to obstruct the course of justice. Six charges in total. After growing public pressure following his original release, the police decided to rearrest Melbourne, and according to the cops, the man has since confessed that he was lying the whole time. He was in fact the driver, and when he saw that Williams was motionless, that's when he panicked and dumped his body. Melbourne will be back in court July 22nd. Following multiple days of public bickering between the Prime Minister and the Mayor of Georgetown over drainage issues, the two finally met in person yesterday, and several areas were agreed for immediate assistance, including more staff for the city to man pumps, as well as fuel aid for said pumps. The government has until June 15th to respond to the United Nations Committee on the Elimination of Racial Discrimination over allegations of human rights violations committed against the indigenous community of Chinese Landing and the Wapichan people. However, Stubrick News says that they have since reached out to Gail Teixeira for a comment on the matter. She has yet to respond to their inquiries. In a letter dated April 29, 2022, United Nations CERT highlighted the complaints received as well as Ghana's non-response to various letters requesting information over the years. Last night, 25-year-old Joel Ramlaw died after he lost control of his vehicle and crashed into a trench along the Good Hope Mahaika Access Road on the East Coast. According to reports, Ramlaw was drinking at a shop in Mahaika before getting behind the wheel. He was taken to the nearest hospital, where he was declared dead on arrival. Now it's time to tell you about Best Buy's Car of the Week. Currently on sale is this 2016 Suzuki Jimny Sierra 4-wheel drive. It comes with regular and low-range 4-wheel drive, Bluetooth, mug rims, new tires, TV, CD, stereo, fog lamps, back camera, and much more. Buy cash for $3.4 million, or pay as low as $700,000 down, with around $67,000 monthly for 5 years, and it is yours. Call or WhatsApp 662-0844 for more info, or visit the showrooms at Lot 171 Bureau Street, Queenstown, or Lot 2 Lamar Street, and tell them the Rico sent you for this sweet deal. On Wednesday, Kanu intercepted a vehicle with some $8 million worth of marijuana on the East Coast. When officers attempted to stop the white Fielder wagon, the driver refused, prompting a chase that ended in Haslington, New Scheme, where the driver reportedly stopped and then fled into the nearby bushes. He reportedly got away, but the 39.9 kilos of weed was confiscated by the police. The Ghana Prison Service has just released its latest statistics for its agriculture program, and according to the numbers, our nation's inmates are literally growing tons of food. For the first half of the year, the GPS reaped 2,085 kilos of boulanger, 979 kilos of borer, 1,463 kilos of bok choy, almost 600 kilos of pumpkin, 300 kilos of papaya, nearly 600 kilos of passion fruit, over 200 kilos of cherry, 9,831 kilos of chicken, and 941 trays of eggs. Cauliflower, pineapple, bananas, and plantains were also reaped. So far, 60 inmates are currently being trained in agricultural production, all in an effort to make the nation's prison system self-sufficient. I love that idea. I think it is a great idea. That's why I'll keep updating you on its progress. Today, American Vice President Kamala Harris declared that Caribbean nations can now access funding for their energy infrastructure projects through the Partnership to Address the Climate Crisis 2030. Under the PACC 2030, the U.S. will support energy infrastructure security and climate-resilient projects from beginning to end. She promised that the U.S. will work with CARICOM nations to identify new clean energy projects and will provide technical assistance to ensure the projects are viable and appealing to investors. However, she did not specify if natural gas pipelines and gas-to-energy plants would be included under the program. For the best crotch in Ghana, wait. That should read, for all size of clutch disc and pressure plates for heavy-duty trucks in Ghana, check out Powered Automotive. Get this and other high-quality truck parts at the lowest prices. Visit them at Lot 1161 EE Eccles. Or call them on telephone number 697-0171. Save big on truck parts at Powered Automotive, the number one heavy-duty truck parts store in Ghana. Yesterday morning, during something that could be described as nothing short of a miracle, a 7-day-old baby boy survived a serious car crash on the Essequibo coast with only a few scratches and bruises despite being thrown from the vehicle. The driver of the vehicle, Bentley George, had reportedly lost control while negotiating a turn and hit a concrete post before ending up in a canal. While the impact launched the newborn out of the open window of the car, eyewitnesses report that, all things considered, the child was okay, just a little bruised and scratched up. However, the boy's mother and the driver are currently hospitalized in a serious condition. Now for today's oil update. By 2027, ExxonMobil is set to ramp up production at Guyana's Stabroek Block to around 1.2 million barrels of oil per day. This will make Guyana the highest per capita oil producer in the world. As of June 10th, Brent oil was trading at just over US$123 per barrel. At that price, at 1.2 million barrels per day, the Stabroek Block output would amount to approximately US$147.6 million. This number is expected to be reached after the fourth and largest FPSO, the One Guyana, comes online. Currently, there are two FPSO vessels producing over 330,000 barrels of oil per day. It seems like iOil needs to invest in better trucks, as the newsroom is reporting that one of the oil company's fuel tankers sprung a major leak while transporting gasoline on the East Bank Public Road near Diamond. But judging from the basin on the road, it seems like some driver just couldn't sit back and watch all that precious fuel go to waste. It might not be robbery season, but the streets are still mean. That's why you need to get security for your home and business through Sheriff Security Service. Sheriff Security offers well-trained guards, armed and unarmed patrol, marine patrol, canine services. These people even got drones. Why? Because your security is their highest priority. You've seen the rest, now hire the best. Hire Sheriff Security today. Now for our stupid news of the day. You know what I think is stupid? The reactive thinking that goes on in this nation. Today, Minister Ben announced that never again will an artist like Skeng be allowed to perform publicly in Guyana. But here's the problem. Artists like Skeng and others are not the cause of youth problems in Guyana. While their music is not for everyone, I mean, especially not for me, but they do not change people's moral independence and personal autonomy. These are all personal decisions. Nevertheless, the issue here isn't the lyrics of the song, but the fact that we have people in our society who see it fit to do certain things and allow the music to fuel a certain way of life. Skeng can never come here again, but the Dutch thugs, as the kids like to call them, will still remain. Skeng didn't command that gang to attack the school yesterday. Skeng did not bring a gun to Lodge Secondary School. Skeng didn't trigger this nation's crime wave. Besides, before him, it was Cartel. And before him, it was Bounty Killer. But banning Bounty Killer nor Cartel didn't suddenly solve all of Guyana's problems, did it? Of course not. If you want to ban something to improve Guyana and the nation's youth, how about we ban classism, racism, and political corruption? In fact, let's go crazy and ban hunger, homelessness, illiteracy, and youth unemployment. Unless if we address these underlying issues, you could ban every single song in the world and we'd still end up in the same place we've always been, riddled with crime and with a disaffected youth population. Fix the issues and society will improve. Simple as that. Now for our uncut news, views poll question of the day. Every day we pose a question about current events in Guyana, the region, the diaspora, and how you fear it leads to us. Yesterday, we asked what should be done to help stem youth violence. Guy Bryan says, too many broken homes. A lot of young men are being raised without a stable father figure. We need to get back to stable homes. I agree. And in fact, Ian King seems to agree as well. He says, increase teachers' pay to attract more male teachers who may be able to mentor and be role models for the male students. Blessed Tawana says, I believe that the Ministry of Education, the Child Care Protection Agency, and the police force should work together to create a plan where a special policing group can educate the schools about gun violence, the consequences of violence, etc. But the police should be trained first as it relates to the natural endowment of a child. The Education Ministry should bring back prayers and special programs that will promote good morals and family values. The Child Care Protection Agency needs to up their game and provide more counseling to students and teachers. Not every parent knows how to raise a child. This means that there should be continuous child-rearing programs at clinics and in the communities that are affected the most. If they get serious, change can happen. I have a lot to say, but I will stop there. Indeed, this actually has to be an effort from not just the government, but of course the private sector and various different ideas coming together. So I'm loving the ideas so far. And finally, Mark Watson says, this is off topic, but I don't think the government should be giving away so much money. Rather, the government should improve the healthcare system, work on government agencies such as the NIH, GRA, the Ministry of Housing, etc., to serve citizens professionally, timely, and definitely not in a stressful manner. Those monies could also be given to public servants as an increase of salary. Indeed. I also like those ideas, and I'm sure they'll do great for the economy and, of course, people's well-being. You can multiply your cash by selling Digicel Top-Up. This is a legit way you can earn so much money at your business or to supplement your current hustle. Become a Top-Up vendor quick and easy by linking with Cellular Plus. Call them on telephone number 685-3109 for more info. Now for tonight's question. The Home Affairs Ministry has just banned Skeng and other musical artists like him from performing in Ghana. Do you support the move to ban him? Why or why not? I want you to think about that question. Tell us in the comments below. If your response is good enough, we just might feature it in our next episode. Anyway, that's all the time we have for tonight, and check us out on Monday for another. Until then, I'm Rico Bulford saying, have a great weekend. And as always, don't drink and drive. We'll end up on Monday's episode the hard way. Ha! Good night, folks.